away.
Okay.
No, put it there.
I apologize. That's the broadcast. We started like this already.
No, you can actually put it right here. Like, right, in between. You cannot put it in between.
No, le pied est trop large.
Yeah, look. Yeah, yeah. A little bit more into it. It's like a doom. No. We have right here this this green screen. Alright, my people. There is your boy Dr. Kizomba, but we're gonna start playing the vampire right now. Sava. Where is the TV?
Hello.
Alright, so we're gonna play vampire right now for you guys, okay? So I got right here my associate Booties in the building. Okay, so this is a very important game. Because we do start reading.
This?
Mm-hmm.
We've already read this.
So that they know. They don't remember like the people that was here yesterday.
even if based on proven medical knowledge from 1918, vampires sometimes take liberties when establishing possible links between scientific theories and supernatural creatures for theatrical purposes. In other words, do not try to cure any disease with any of the recipes.
They're talking about the rats.
No! They're talking about, you can do recipes.
Recipes?
On l'a pas encore fait.
Oh yeah. Because we're spending the money on something else.
Yeah. And no bats were harmed during the making of this game.
Oh, they're saying that no rats were harmed during the making of this game? Are they sure? Okay, my people, we're gonna start right now. Press start. Did you remember what were we doing and what were we doing? Okay, vampire, start, man. But where do I go? Night shift?
You just have one.
Continue night shift. Oh Lord, we got Stein. So we talked to everybody, right?
I think so, yeah. But in fact, I'm not sure because there was some questions that were locked, and maybe we have to unlock them.
we're like still going to the mission, right?
My guess is they're recruiting for some vengeance.
In the meantime, the boys are waiting for our...
Yeah, there.
Good evening, sir.
Who the fuck are you? Don't you see I'm busy here?
Dr. Jonathan Reed, that's who I am. And who are you?
Ah, some fancy gentleman we've got here. Clear off. We don't want strangers on our streets.
So you won't tell me your name?
Listen.
The name is Booth Digby. Maybe I'll ask my boys to break one or two of your bones, just so you remember it.
Okay. You're a vigilant, right?
Are you some kind of vigilante patrolling these streets at night?
Something like that, but the police aren't in charge here. We are, see?
What's your gang, Ray?
So, tell me about your gang, then.
What? Have you got a death wish? You really want me to answer that?
Well, yes. You seem so proud of your status. Why not tell me who you're working for?
Oi! I'm the boss, all right? The Wet Boot Boys work for me. All of them. Situation round here is better than other districts because of us. Because of me.
So you're a concerned criminal, is that it?
Using funny jokes about me and my boys, are you? Fuck. You must have some balls.
I saw many men like you during the war, Mr. Digby. Greedy little cockroaches who feed on despair.
I could kill you for saying that. But, nah. You've been a soldier. I can respect that.
What can you tell me about this part of town?
Things ain't that bad, thanks to us. We give people what they need, and we control this borough.
Well, you're not doing a very good job. People are still dying here, like everywhere else.
Yeah, well, we can't be everywhere all the time. And Edwina says if we can find more guns, we could be more efficient.
More efficient? Really? You should probably tell Edwina that guns are useless against diseases and infections.
Incredible. You know what? You're lucky she can't hear you right now. She's more smart than patient. My sweet queen of the docks.
Everything is a hint, right?
Goodbye, Mr. Digby.
She's got no idea who she's dealing with.
Good evening, miss. I am Dr. Reed. May I ask you a few questions?
Who are you? What do you want?
As I just told you, I'm a doctor. From the Pembroke Hospital, actually.
The Pembroke Hospital, you say? I don't have any money for you leeches.
I'm not here for charity, miss...
Miss Edwina Cox. So what do you want, then? Fancy buying something from me, maybe?
Oh, she trades. Go straight to it, or no? Yeah, so you still use your husband's name, right?
You still use your husband's name, Edwina. Why is that?
Why shouldn't I? He may be a bloody bastard, but I'm still his wife and his name means something round here.
Are you aware of what happened to him?
Yes. I'm sure he fought till the end and looked death in the eyes. The boys will mourn him. Except one of them, maybe.
What can you tell me about your work?
I'm a businesswoman. I buy and sell things, and I send my wet boot boys after anyone who don't play nice with me.
Gang member and shopkeeper. Can't be easy running double shifts.
If you're interested, I may find use of a doctor who can freely walk across the city, you know.
You're quite blunt, aren't you?
I like people who know what they want and say what they think. This is a time of great opportunity for those ready to embrace their destiny.
What can you tell me about this part of town?
You can't trust anyone around here. As soon as you lower your guard, you can be sure some arsehole will take advantage of you.
Really? Don't you think that's a little bit excessive?
Bastards, all of them. This region only responds to violence and threats.
You sound like you're thinking of somebody in particular.
Take the gravediggers of Southwark. They must pay me every week, but it looks like they forgot who gave them permission to steal from the dead.
Looting corpses in a mass grave. That is a new low.
Whatever. Hey, since you're a doctor and all, maybe you can access that forbidden area and remind those bastards what they owe.
Oh, Lord. Hold on a second, people. Hold on. She continued laughing. So, okay, what's up?
So, you know, you have a lot to do.
Well, this one.
Blood quality. Any Gillingham, je sais même plus qui c'est.
This guy right here.
Okay, but who are they?
I'm putting them together.
What can you tell me about your work?
I'm a businesswoman. I buy and sell things, and I send my wet boot boys after anyone who don't play nice with me.
Gang member and shopkeeper. Can't be easy running double shifts.
If you're interested, I may find use of a doctor who can freely walk across the city, you know.
Then I'm not interested.
I don't know what is the information that is...
Boo Digby looks at you with love-struck eyes. Tell me, Edwina, is the feeling mutual?
You have no idea how refreshing it can be for a woman to receive all the pleasure she needs, for once.
I'll take your word for it.
What is it, Doctor? A woman's not supposed to talk about these things.
What the essence of self-hard?
Behind all your crude words and your attitude, I sense romance and a soft heart, Miss Cox.
Romance? I have no time for such rubbish. I use Booth like I use everyone else.
Boo Digby looks at you with love-struck eyes. Tell me, Edwina, is the feeling mutual?
You have no idea how refreshing it can be for a woman to receive all the pleasure she needs, for once.
I'll take your word for it.
What is it, Doctor? A woman's not supposed to talk about these things.
Behind all your crude words and your attitude, I sense romance and a soft heart, Miss Cox.
Romance? I have no time for such rubbish. I use Booth like I use everyone else.
Oh, damn. I messed up the question.
What do you mean?
Yeah, because she said I use Booth like...
Can I see what you have to sell?
As long as you have money, I'll show you all I have.
Our ship got the same things in mind, the tools that I need.
The sewer dog's fault, they say. Then the gangs, the epidemics, everyone's throwing the blame.
See me, my sweet queen. Perhaps we should have listened to what the idiot had to say. You again. What do you want?
Goodbye, Mr. Digby. Thank you.
the hang of it. Like, I'm getting better.
It ain't human! Kill it!
I cannot enter. Are you sure you'll be able to reach the docks alone?
Young man, I am perfectly capable of defending myself.
the Budut.
That's for me?
My majesty fatigue.
Sister? Why?
Put them smoking weed. This